Gibbert. I'm going to go over some of the close-in stuff we were talking about. The first thing is this 2 and 45. So if I have somebody, we're in a tight enclosure and he's coming forward, I don't want to just back up. And sideways is okay. But actually, if he comes in and I step forward 45 to one direction or the other, it's a much better angle against him. So that's a big part. Because I actually want to have my escape plan in set. So even if we're in this tiny little box, if I'm here and I back up, he's going to pin me into the side of the box. Right? And even if I try and roll around him, he can smush me into the side of the box. So if I start to go, he can smush me into the side of the box. So I want to engage him more in the middle so that I have somewhere to go. So when he comes in, I'm going to step forward into the time and then roll through. So I'm basically exchanging so that I still have escape. What I was talking about with the stepping under the sword is this. If I'm here and he throws a snap at my head, I'm going to step forward and block. And this is what I mean by under the sword. I'm going to roll. See how I'm under his sword? If I don't do that, if I just block, okay, there's a lot of stuff he can still do. I want some control and want some throughness of his sword. So I can do it on the onside, where I'm here, and I can do some cool shovey stuff if you're buying. Or I can be under his sword. Same way if he throws an offside. If we're here, he throws an offside and I block it, okay, see how there's still a lot of stuff he can do. So, but if I step forward 45 on the offside, and I'm rolling under his sword, I have some cool stuff I can do. Okay. The double step is we're going to start a gather to one side and move to the other. The way I like to do this is he's here, he's coming forward. As he starts to move, I will step and bounce because I want to get his momentum of his charge going one direction so I can go another way. It doesn't have to be much. I just need a little bit of momentum because he's coming forward. His reaction will be slower. So he starts to move. Often that's what's going to happen. All we need is that little bit of a turn. So it's not a huge step. I'm just going to step, land on the ball of my foot so I can push off into the other direction. Very important. And I can pair that with some of that under stuff. So if he's coming in and I step this way, under. Now from here, I can easily still get out. So that's the step in 45. That's the concept of under the sword. That's the double step. If he shoots low, we can get on top of the sword. So if we're in here and he likes to throw a wrapper thing, again, I'm stepping forward in 45, because if I do this out here, there's a good chance I'm going to lose the sword or get hit in the hands, which also sucks. So I want to step in, and then I can start doing some of the back edge stuff, or even this Meyer cut, which is really nice. Okay, pair that with some footwork. The final thing is the pinning of the sword. So if he comes in, and now he gets his shield on me, and we're here, and he's pushing my sword into my body. Guys love to do this. What you're going to do is you're going to roll your hips, and you're going to transition so that instead of the sword or your gauntlet, that's what they get onto, this roll, see how it's a bit of a pop. I'm not pushing against him. I'm not fighting his force. In fact, if he pushes, that helps me, okay? Because what's going to happen is as I roll, that pressure is going to end up onto my armor instead of my sword. I'm going to hit him in the head, okay? And it's important to turn the body. If I do this, I'm going to lock up, and he's got a lot of good stuff. If I have a loose hand and I turn my hip, it's much easier because now I'm facing his threat. And you can pair this with a pivot step if you want, which gets you even more off the line. So those are some easy things to do from the inside range. So start with that. Let me know if you have questions.